Hi friends, the topic for the day is India Unsafe for Women Perception Poll 2018. Now, before we move on to the topic, let me tell you, women and gender, they come within the Indian society section, which is under your GS1. And this report, this topic is basically Thomson Reuters report, India Unsafe for Women. But we do not need an elaborate analysis on this report per se, but for your mains. But I've chosen this topic since it gives some scope to discuss various women-related issues, which could be a good pointer to your GS1 answers and also your essay. So this is how we go about. First we will be talking in brief about the report, what their perception is versus what our reality is. What is India's reality? How are we faring on the indicators cited by them? What are the strategic interventions made by India and what is the way forward? Now, moving on. Now, Thomson Reuters is a news agency and a perception poll conducted by this agency ranks India as the most dangerous nation. Now, what is alarming here is it is cited to be more dangerous than countries like your Syria, Afghanistan, Somalia, Saudi Arabia, etc. Now, we know that most of these countries are infamous for infringement of women's rights. Now, India, which is aspiring to be a major superpower, such a perception is definitely a blot or a black mark on world's largest democracy. So here, as you see in the slide, these are the indicators used to conduct the survey. But the credibility of the report is doubtful. One, because the methodology used is perception, which means it is a subjective finding and there are no verifiable facts to support the poll. And the respondents were just 538 experts from various domains. And again, in a country with 1.3 billion population, half of the population are female, women. So this is a very small sample size to arrive at such a conclusion. So let us see, let us support our facts here, arguments here. For example, your reality, perception versus reality. Now, if you see World Bank study, as per a World Bank study, India's maternal mortality rate is 174. Now, maternal mortality rate is the number of registered maternal deaths per 1 lakh live births. Now, per 1 lakh live births, having a maternal mortality rate of 174 isn't that bad in the sense that we have other countries faring worse than us. Next, moving on to another World Bank survey, which says, we have a labor participation of women in India, which is at 25.4%. Now, this data is also comparatively better than other nations mentioned in the poll. Now, coming to your World Economic Forum's Global Gender Gap Report, India has been ranked 108th compared to 144 countries. Now, this ranking is ahead. We are ahead of Pakistan, which is only 143, which means it is one of the last nations in Global Gender Gap. Saudi Arabia is ranked at 138. If you see in the right-hand side, we have this data on female genital mutilation. Now, UNICEF, as per UNICEF's report, among girls younger than 14 years of age, there is no record of India having or India practicing this female genital mutilation. So, these datas, I've not listed all here. These are some of the major datas, which prove that on some major indicators, we are not as bad as we are perceived to be. Now, we may not be as bad as what Reuters have perceived us to be so, but we definitely have some shortcomings and we need to work on these to ensure a safer place for women. So, let us have a look at them. Now, let's see how India fares and what is India's reality. Now, if you see on the health front, we have not made significant improvements in certain sections, especially if you look at the Global Nutrition Report on the right-hand side, if you see, in Pakistan has 2.5 crore women between 15 to 49 years suffering from anemia. China has 9 crore. And look at India's figure. It is 17 crore, which is like about 51% of the population. Indian women are anemic, which is like one of the highest in the world. Talking about your mental health, World Health Organization says that by 2020, 20% of Indian population are going to suffer from mental illness. Now, of this 20% of population, the rate of women would be between 20 to 25%. Also, WHO has set 8 health targets, and India happens to meet just 2 out of the 8 targets of WHO. Now, have a look at this. Economic participation of women. Now, India Development Report, which is also by World Bank, says that India has the lowest female participation in workforce. That is 128th among 131 countries. So, if you see, India's percentage is very, very less, as in 17%. This is a report by McKinsey. And sub-Saharan African countries fare better than us in this aspect. And China is way, way ahead with 41% here. Now, there's a lot of statistics here. They are to support your answers. Now, talking about violence here, the different forms of violence in India would be rape, sexual abuse, stalking, indecent exposure, all of these. Other than that, we have non-sexual violence also, as in dowry, female infanticide, domestic violence, etc. Now, if you look at this figure, of 167 countries, India has been ranked the fourth in the world. So this is a huge number. Also, India has very, very high rate of child marriages among women. Now, a lot of people think trafficking is only prostitution or sex work. But then it also includes your forced labor, organ harvestry, etc. Now, some of our cultural practices also contribute to a lot of non-sexual violence, or even sexual violence for that matter. Now, earlier we had made a mention of UNICEF report, which mentions about female genital mutilation below 14 years. But we don't have any data there. But actually in India, in the Bora community, girls' genitals are mutilated using a blade to control their sexuality. Now, if you talk about widows are considered ill women in Indian society. And by considering it, we restrict their mobility and their choices in life. Now, again, talking about your menstruation, there's a taboo attached to menstruation. And there is a notion of impurity and pollution attached to these practices. Now, it is not that as a country, we are not aware of the shortcomings that we have. We have made several strategic interventions, especially in these areas, education, health, judicial and labor, to curb these problems in their respective fields. Please check your material. The schemes have been listed there. Nevertheless, I'll mention a few here. Education, that is Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. We have your Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, RTE, Right to Education. Now, I have used a lot of visuals for your visual retention and hope it helps. Health intervention, we have your Janani Suraksha Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. I've listed all of them, like most important ones in the material. Please go through them. These are some of the legal provisions. And important ones being your sexual harassment of women at workplace, the preconception and prenatal diagnostic techniques act, medical termination of pregnancy termination act, etc. Now, labor welfare interventions would be your Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, Mahila Ehat, and Maternity Benefit Act 2017. Now, besides these, we also have digital applications to ensure women health and safety. The two examples that I've given here is of Raksha and Chilla. Chilla means shout. Yeah. So these apps work by generating an SMS which alerts the police and help nab the criminals. So we have spoken about all of these. Now, are these interventions reaping any benefit? Yes, they are. Like, you know, these are just four examples that I've given here. See, most of the answers require you to write in about 250 words. So, keeping it short so that you retain all of this and write it in the exam. Now, first one would be your Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Now, Haryana, as we all know, has the worst child sex ratio. But with the intervention of Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, we have had 914 girls per 1,000 boys in 2017 as compared to 876 girls in 2015. Next, Narega. Economy survey report says that 54% work were undertaken by female labor force, which is a good sign. Then talking about your Pradhan Mantri Matra Vandana Yojana. Now this scheme is a maternity benefit program providing financial aid to pregnant and lactating mothers. Now here we have about 17 lakh beneficiaries enrolled and have benefited from this program. Now moving on to the last one, here would be M Shakti. Now, M Shakti is a mobile application which is used to aid health workers even in the remotest area. Now, it is reported to have been used by 329 ashas to benefit 16,000 mothers. Now, in rural India, a mobile broadband initiative achieving this is a big, big accomplishment. So, what is the way forward to ensure safety for women? Now, first here would be increasing your police presence and women council at stations. Now, doing this helps the visibility of police force. Now, when there is more visibility, it becomes easier to respond to crimes and apprehend the criminals. Now, also because of visibility, it acts as a deterrent to wrongdoers. Second, upgrading your public infrastructure, transport and street lighting. Street lighting make a huge difference in reducing crime rate in women. It is not that in broad daylight these crimes do not happen. It does, but in darker areas facilitate more crime. And because, you know, since it facilitates more crime, women's movement and freedom also gets restricted. Now, we have setting up of fast track special courts. Fast track special courts because justice delayed is almost like justice denied. So these fast courts, it's not that they must act only in a speedy way, but it should also expedite justice in a speedy way. Now prosecution machinery. Now prosecution machinery, strengthening of this is needed because to have a dedicated capacity by having more manpower, how? By sanctioning additional posts for public prosecutors, etc. Now, at the same time, judges also need to be sensitized regarding women-related issues. Also, if you look into the figure, there are states without high court female judges and the data is as recent as December 2017. Next, we have improving quality of investigation. Now, you know, this is very important in the sense because the rate of conviction will depend on the quality of investigation there. Moving on, you know, we need to have gender sensitivity quizzes and curriculum in schools to uncover gender bias. Now, gender sensitivity program in schools, how they help is by generating respect for individuals irrespective of which sex you belong to. Also, it helps remove gender stereotype. Now, last one there we have is visibility of the issue in public domain. Now, visibility of the issue in public domain. Here we have Maharashtra as a case study. They have displayed Gudda Guddi boards. Now, Gudda Guddi means boy child, girl child. Boards to update birth statistics in the public. If India is aspiring really high, it needs to take its women along and bring in a participatory approach. Now, we have report by two bodies, one is International Monetary Forum and the other by McKinsey report. Now, International Monetary Forum says that, you know, when you bring in the women level of participation on par with men, India's GDP could be increased by 27% of additional GDP in 2025, which means our annual GDP would be upped by 1.4%. Also, in conclusions, you can write about McKinsey reports where it says that women's participation in the labor force can add $12 trillion to global growth, and India could add as much as $700 billion. Yeah. Now this statement is this is a quote by Jawaharlal Nehru, And the model question for the day is, you can tell the condition of a nation by looking at the status of its women. Do you agree? Substantiate. Write it in for 250 words. You can mail us your answers in the given ID here. That is lucidmains, L-U-C-I-D, mains 2018@gmail.com. Once you have uploaded your answers, you can always join our Telegram group, and feedback would be given via Telegram channels. So that's all for the day. Thank you.